Hello everyone, welcome to lecture 15 of Mathematical Modeling and Simulation. In this lecture we are going to look at Microscopic Traffic Flow Model. We are already familiar with now Macroscopic Traffic Flow Model. So let's try to understand what is this Microscopic Traffic Flow Model, and then we'll have a specific kind of microscopic model, which is car following model, followed by certain examples. And in the last, we'll discuss some differences between macroscopic and microscopic. So it's clear from the name, because it includes the word micro in it. So micro means something tiny in very much detail. So we want to understand something at the micro level, means we want to do a detailed analysis of it. So in microscopic model, individual cars or vehicles are observed and data analysis done in the detailed level. So this is clear-cut difference from what we do in macroscopic model. There we do not follow or focus on an individual car or vehicle. Rather, there we are interested in the average or the aggregate behavior of the cluster of a large number of vehicles as a whole. What is their average speed? What is the average density on the road? What is the average flow rate? Although we don't use the word average there, but they all are average. While in microscopic, we are not going to do that. We'll be modeling the behavior of individual cars and vehicles. There are many examples. Car following model is one example, and cellular automata is another example. So in this lecture, we are going to focus on the car following model. So before starting up that, this is an interesting observation, which was a text I found in one of the document. It says that driving, apart from walking, talking and eating, is the most widely executed skill in the world today, and possibly the most challenging. So that's an interesting fact about driving. And obviously, why specifically we are talking about driving, because in this lecture we are focusing on the car following models, which has a lot to do with the driving. So let's begin exploring the car following model. So it's based on a theory which tells you follow the leader. So following another vehicle on a single lane highway with no passing allowed has been characterized as one of the driving tasks. So this is one of the driving tasks, that you have to follow your leader. You cannot pass, means you cannot overtake. So passing means overtaking is not allowed. So this is all but follow the leader theory, that when you are driving on a single lane highway, you do not have any option of overtaking. So the only thing you can do is follow your leader, means follow the vehicle in front of you. So that's as simple, the meaning of car following, the meaning of follow the leader theory. So let's do some mathematical calculation here. So this is the direction of motion. This is the nth vehicle. And this one is n plus 1th vehicle. Let d be the distance between two vehicles. It's basically measured from rear of nth vehicle to the front of n plus 1th vehicle. So you can see it's distance between cars. It's also known as headway, space headway, or distance headway. So there are different words used for it. And suppose this point is beginning of the road or highway, say x equals to 0. And this point is x and t, the distance is x and t, which represents the position, or you can say location, of nth car on highway at any time t. And this is the position of xn plus 1 t. It represents position of n plus 1th vehicle on highway at time t. So we have defined the individual positions of the follower and the leader vehicle. So if L be the length of car, which is assumed to be same for every car, so capital L is the length of the car, then clearly we can write xn t is equal to xn plus 1 t plus d plus L, which implies xn t minus xn plus 1 t is equal to d plus l. So that's an equation we need to remember because we'll be using it in further calculation. So it's saying that basically the difference in the positions of nth and n plus 1th vehicle at a time is equal to the difference between the distance between them and the length of the car. So that's how far the positions of two consecutive vehicles are from each other. So let this be L, this be D. So we have just defined this xn plus 1, that is xn, and the difference between them is D plus L. So call it equation 1. So if the length of road is LR and the number of cars on road is NR, then LR is L plus D into NR. It implies NR is LR by L plus D. NR by LR is 1 by L plus D, means that is density. Call it equation number 2, because if you go by the basic definition of density, density is the number of cars, which is NR, per unit length of the road. So a particular length of the road, a section of the road is considered having length LR. So in that section, these many cars are coming. So that's the basic definition of density. So using this, we have computed, this is nothing but 1 by L plus D. So basically what we are trying to do, we are trying to find average density here, even in the car following model. So that will make a connection between the macroscopic and the microscopic model. So this is turning out to be 1 by L plus D. So we need to remember this equation. So you can see this rho is 1 by L plus D we just derived. And this was our equation number 1. Xn t minus xn plus 1t is L plus D. This was this equation. So you connect these two, you will get rho. The average density is 1 over the reciprocal of the difference between the positions of nth and n plus 1th vehicle at any time t. So this we need to remember because we'll use it. So now what is this follow the leader concept mathematically? It says that response is equal to stimulus into sensitivity, where sensitivity is a parameter and it varies as per the model. Response means acceleration or deceleration of the driver. And stimulus means the situation which triggers the response. So the stimulus can be the relative distance between follower and leader, or it can be the difference between speeds, or it can be simply speed of the leading car or vehicle. So that's all about follow the leader concept, and that's very easy to understand. Suppose you're driving on a road and obviously there's no overtaking allowed. So whatever your motion will be, or whatever your reaction to your driving, means whatever the way you drive, you accelerate or decelerate or you maintain a constant speed. So that's all purely decided by the vehicle in front of you, which is giving you a stimulus, which is giving you a trigger. Because if the vehicle in front of you suddenly apply brakes, you also have to slow down and apply brakes. So that's your response to the stimulus coming from the leading vehicle. So that's the meaning of stimulus. So if you are looking at the difference between the distance between your car and the next car, so if the distance is too large, you will try to accelerate because you want to cover up that distance. So that means your response is decided by that stimulus with the information which you are getting from the vehicle in front of you, and it's multiplied with a parameter, which is sensitivity parameter. So it really depends upon how sensitively you are driving according to the stimulus, because some people drive like they don't care howsoever the vehicle in front drives. They will try to maintain a constant speed or a constant way. They have a different way of driving. So that's very rare, but some people's sensitivity, or sometimes the traffic is like that. Because if you model on a highway, the sensitivity can have a different sense, while if you model on a road inside a city, so there you have to be very much sensitive towards this. So that sensitivity parameter varies as per the circumstances and as per the model, but it is definitely a part of the model. So that's all about the follow the leader concept. So now we'll translate this into the mathematical language. So mathematically, if x and t is the position of nth vehicle at time t, then dx n by dt is speed and the double derivative is the acceleration. So we know the response of n plus 1th vehicle is given by this, where this is acceleration or deceleration, that's the response of the follower vehicle n plus 1th. This is the stimulus, which is the difference between the speed between n plus 1th and nth vehicle. So that's the stimulus, and Kp is the sensitivity parameter. And it has dimension of per unit time. So that will make this equation dimensionally consistent, because on left hand side you have acceleration, the dimension is Lt minus 2. While on right hand side you have the speed, so dimension is Lt minus 1. So to match the dimension on both the sides, you have to multiply the speed with another constant or parameter whose dimension is of per unit time. So that sensitivity parameter is gender, dimension is per unit time. So that's your model. That's one kind of a car following model, because I gave you the general examples that this can be also the stimulus, this can be the stimulus. So here we have assumed a particular kind of stimulus, which is the speed difference. So now we'll analyze this model. So again, rewriting this, which we have just derived. So if dxn by dt is greater than dxn plus 1 by dt, that means the leading vehicle is driving faster than the follower, means than you, then follower will naturally accelerate. Means the value of this double derivative is going to be positive, which will make this Kp negative. And if dxn by dt is less than dxn plus 1 by dt, that is leader is slow, then the follower also have to slow down. So in that case, he will decelerate. So the value of double derivative is negative, means Kp is positive. So this tells you that this Kp, the sensitivity parameter, keeps changing with respect to time. It's a function of time, and even within a particular model, it can have different values at different times. So right now we are not going into the detail of the sensitivity parameter. So that's just a further discussion on the model. So this equation contains m. So if you put n equals to 1, 2, 3 up to capital N, where capital N is the number of cars or the total number of vehicles on the road section considered, because you will be modeling a small part of the road or even a large part of the road, but that will be a finite section. Then we will get a system of capital N second order ordinary differential equations, and further these equations are coupled. So that is computationally challenging or difficult to solve this car following model or microscopic model. So that's the again a difference you can point out from the macroscopic model. In macroscopic, you had one equation which was derived purely from the conservation law of mass, and you could have second equation in second order models. There we did not study higher order models, but in second order models you have two partial differential equations. While here, even if your capital N is say very small, say 100, then you are going to get 100 equations, because by putting n equals to 1, you get one equation, putting n equals to 2, you get another equation, and so on. So you'll get a large system of coupled second order ordinary differential equations. The meaning of coupled means when in the equation of n plus 1th vehicle, n plus 1 is also coming, n is also coming. So in the equation of n plus 2th vehicle, there will be involvement of nth plus 1th and n plus 2th. So it's because of the interaction. You are not driving independently, you are interacting with each other. The follower and leaders are interacting with each other. So that's why you get a coupled system. So this system is computationally difficult to solve. That's why further, the UCAR following model we have just formulated, we will not be talking anything about its solution, how to solve this, because see, theoretically or manually we cannot solve it. All what you have to do is to write a program for it, and that's also going to be computationally challenging because it's going to take much, much time. So I'm not going to discuss how to solve this. We just want to now further analyze and determine the speed density relationship from this. So speed we know is speed of n plus 1th car is given by t by dt of xn plus 1t, and d by dt of xn plus 1t can be found by integration of the acceleration, which is minus kp dxn plus 1 by dt minus dxn by dt. If you integrate, you will get this plus cn plus 1, which is nothing but the constant of integration. So you get the connection between speed and position. So the speed of n plus 1th car is dependent on the space headway or the distance headway or the difference in the positions of n plus 1th and the nth car. So we are trying to formulate a speed density relationship. So you have already connected speed with the distance between the vehicle's position. And the formula which we just derived is this, and we know that rho is this, so this will give you minus 1 by rho. This is star we have derived earlier. Substituting that, we get dxn plus 1 by dt is kp by rho plus cn plus 1, which is v is kp by rho plus c, assuming average speed of all the cars is v. See, why we are deriving these expressions? Because we want to look at the average speed and the average density. Although the calculation is coming from microscopic level, but still we can always define these quantities here also. So the way they are defined are different as compared to the macroscopic model. But we want to make a comparison between the speed density relationships coming from micro model and the macro model. So here we are assuming that the all vehicles or cars are driving with same speed. So that's the average speed, which is v. So therefore this v is independent of n. I have not written as a function of the nth vehicle. It's same for all. Kp by rho, and even the constant of integration is independent of n. So now what you want to do further? You want to find the value of this constant of integration c. So for that we'll use the condition: when rho is rho max, velocity is 0. So if you put this, you'll get c is minus kp by rho max, and substituting this value of c here, you'll get v is kp 1 by rho minus 1 by rho max. So that's the speed density relationship we get for a car following specific model of this kind. I'm not saying this is generally true for every car following model, but it's for a specific car following model which we have assumed. So this is a speed density relationship. So let's see whether it satisfies the three conditions or not. First condition, it should be decreasing function, so dv by d rho should be negative, which is true. You can check that graphically also. Second condition is satisfied. Third condition is, if rho is 0, v should be v max, but here v is turning out to be infinity. So that means third condition is violated. It's not satisfied. So that means we need to improvise this speed density relationship. It needs improvement, because if you remember, one of the condition of speed density relationship was, if density is 0, the vehicles are free to drive at free flow speed. So this v instead of infinity should be v max, which is not happening here. So therefore this condition is not satisfied. So we need to put an improvisation. So improved speed density relationship. So suppose there exists some critical density, rho critical, below which the cars can drive at their desirable or the free flow speed. So we'll define V like V is V max when rho is less than critical density. Otherwise, it's Kp 1 by rho minus 1 by rho max if rho is greater than equals to rho critical. If you draw this, you'll get this kind of graph. Because up to rho critical, it's constant V max. This one is constant V max. But after rho critical, it's a monotonically decreasing graph. Right? So that's the new speed density relationship which we have just derived. And once we look at speed density relationship, we also want to look at the fundamental diagram which connects density with flow. So flow rate Q is rho into V. Put the value of V, we get rho V max if rho is less than rho critical, and Kp 1 minus rho by rho max if rho is greater than equals to rho critical. If you want to draw this, you will get a triangular profile. So before rho critical, you can see it's a linear function, and even when rho is greater than or equal to rho critical, that's again a linear function. So both the times it's a straight line. So that's why you are getting a triangular fundamental diagram. If you recall the fundamental diagram of macroscopic model, it was vertically downward parabola. So that was a parabolic, while this one is a triangular. So now let's do some calculations. We have just derived these expressions. We have seen it's a triangular diagram. Now we want to know when is the flow rate maximum. So you can see the flow rate is maximum at the peak, and this peak of the triangle is coming at rho is equal to rho critical. So when rho is rho critical, Q is Q max. And rho equals to rho critical is coming here because this is rho greater than equals to. So you'll put rho equals to rho critical in this expression, you will get Q max. So Q max is Kp into 1 minus rho critical by rho max. And if you want to know what is the speed at the maximum flow rate, so that also we'll get from by putting rho equals to rho critical in the expression for V. So let's call it V critical. So it's Kp 1 by rho critical minus 1 by rho max. It's coming from here. And you multiply this equation with rho critical on both the sides, you'll get Kp 1 minus this, which is same as this, which is Q max. So finally, you get this expression connecting the maximum flow rate with the density and the speed. So Q max is rho critical into V critical, where V critical is given by this. So to find V critical, we need to know Kp, rho critical and rho max. So we'll be given this kind of questions and very easily can compute all these things. So let's do a question. It's very simple. If you read the statement, if the average length of a car is 5 meters, what is the density of traffic in a line when its cars are maintaining a distance of 2 car lengths between themselves? And what is the traffic flow if the line is moving at 80 kilometers per hour? So length of car is given 5 meters. 2 car length distance means D. The distance which they are maintaining between the cars is 2 car lengths, means it's 2 into L, which is 10 meters. So density we know, we have derived the formula is 1 by L plus D. So it's 1 by 15 per meter. You can convert that in kilometers. So 1000 by 15 per kilometers. 66.66 cars per kilometer. And they are also asking traffic flow rate, which is rho into V. So 1000 by 15 gets multiplied with 80 kilometer per hour. So you get 5333.33 cars per hour. So that's the flow rate which you get. So that question was just easy. It was just to check how you connect the density with the length of the car and the distance. So this, if you are getting, so directly we know once you have the density, you are given the speed, you can compute the flow rate. Finally, we are going to understand the difference between macro and micro, although most of the differences I have already explained. So let's have a look at them. Macroscopic modeling looks at traffic flow from a global perspective and analogous to a fluid flow, while microscopic gives attention to the details of traffic flow and the interactions. So what kind of interactions means? It's the follow the leader theory is a kind of an interaction, because you are not simply driving independently. Your motion is controlled by the information coming from the vehicle in front of you. So you are indirectly interacting with the information or the front or the leading vehicle. So that kind of interaction is there. Macroscopic model is based on the continuum hypothesis and the conservation law, because we know that the way we derived LWR model, so that was conservation of mass based, while microscopic model are based on leader and follower theory and their interactions. This is a system of one or two PDEs, while this is a system of large number of ordinary differential equations. This I have just explained to you. So this is computationally less expensive, this is computationally expensive. So these are the few differences. There can be more differences also, but I would like to say here that as such there is no claim that this is better or the other is better, because it really depends upon the purpose of modeling, what you want to study with your model, in how much detail you want to do the analysis. So in some situations macro can serve the purpose, while in other situations the micro model can serve the purpose. So both are having their own advantages and limitations. So that's all about this lecture. In the next lecture, we are going to look at the next topic. Our topic of traffic flow modeling is finished.